Now that we're in 2020, the start of a new decade, some things have changed in the laptop world, and some things haven't. Just like last year, people are searching for the perfect laptop to buy for their needs, and our purchasing recommendations still haven't changed between the MacBook Air and the MacBook Pro. So before we go through those recommendations once again, but with a bit of updated information, I first want to go through what's changed since last year, and that's the price.
The best selling laptop in 2020 is the MacBook Air.
So that MacBook Air that Linus was talking about was actually the legacy 2017 model with the super huge bezels, horribly outdated TN display, outdated specs, but overall decent laptop. And I believe that there's one reason why it's the best-selling laptop, and that's because it's the cheapest way to get a MacBook, currently on sale for only $750 on Amazon. Now, what all of those people who bought it might not realize is that the updated MacBook Air, with a much better display, better design, newer specs, bigger trackpad, and more, is also available for just $759 renewed on Amazon. Yes, that's the 2018 MacBook Air with the latest design for only around $750, which is unheard of because the retail price at launch was $1,100. Now, a lot of people steer clear from renewed models because they're not brand new, but for only $750, that's a steal. And plus, Amazon gives you a 90-day money-back guarantee if you have any issues with it, which is much more than the regular 30-day return policy. But this ordeal doesn't end there. We actually found a MacBook Pro renewed for even cheaper, only $740. However, it's the 2017 dual-core model, not the latest 2019 quad-core that we recommend for anyone doing creative work on their laptop. But on the plus side, the older model features physical keys instead of the new touch bar, which some people prefer. So now that we have that knowledge of the prices, let's get into comparing the MacBook Air and the MacBook Pro in 2020. First off, if you're going to be buying one of those renewed models, keep in mind that they're both dual-core models, so performance shouldn't be that different between them, and both of them should still be a great choice. But if you're doing any kind of creative work, I'm talking Photoshop, Lightroom, video editing, programming, working with Logic Pro, or anything else like that, we fully recommend going with the 2019 MacBook Pro with the quad-core CPU. This is going to give you so much more performance. In fact, the base model gives you the best bang for the buck in terms of processor performance for the cash, even beating out the 16-inch MacBook Pro. Now, if you don't really care that much about performance and you just want a very good, reliable laptop, the MacBook Air is an excellent choice, and it actually has a few perks over the Pro. It's got 12 hours of battery life instead of 10 on the Pro. The wedge-shaped design slants the keyboard downward for a more comfortable typing experience. It's more portable, weighing a quarter of a pound less than the Pro. It gets physical function keys, which a lot of people like over the touch bar, and of course, you also get the gold color option, which you don't get on the Pro. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that both of these MacBooks feature the butterfly key switches, which have had issues in the past, so if you want to steer clear of that, we are expecting new models of these laptops coming with an updated keyboard, possibly sometime this year, but there's no guarantees. Now, on the other hand, the MacBook Pro, of course, does get a few perks over the Air, like the larger trackpad that's more convenient. It gets a brighter display with better color accuracy for things like photo and video editing. It gets better quality speakers, and most importantly, much better performance. So to sum up which of these MacBooks you should buy, if you do a lot of typing, you need the most battery life you can get, and you don't really care about performance or any type of editing or creative work, then the MacBook Air is gonna be perfect for you. And if you want a bit more of a premium MacBook with extra horsepower, better speakers, better display, or you do any kind of creative work, 100% absolutely choose the MacBook Pro over the Air. And if you want the best, most powerful MacBook ever made, the newly redesigned 16-inch MacBook Pro with the new Magic Keyboard is a game changer with incredible amounts of performance. We'll have our purchasing guide links to the best deals on all of these MacBooks down in the description below, and if you want to see a deeper dive into the MacBook Air versus the MacBook Pro, watch that video right over there. And if you're not already subscribed, click that circle above to do so right now. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.